Every now and then, we may feel lost in life and we're not sure what path to take, and a lot can be taking a toll on us. It's important to be right where your feet are and remember your why for everything that you do. So here are some tips to help you find that spark again in everything you do. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Pamela and today we're going to be talking all about how to find your spark in life again. For the first 6 months of 2024, I was really struggling with where I wanted my life to go, what was my next step. I had just graduated college and I was kind of all over the place. I really didn't know what I was going to be doing or what I was looking forward to, because I had had this job that I thought was my dream job. I ended up leaving, and then for the following 3 months, I was just trying to get my life back together, and it was quite a mess. But I'm now so grateful for that, because I'm looking back at those first 6 months and I want to turn all of those lessons into opportunities, and that's what I've been working on for the past few weeks now, even for the past few months. And I feel like I have finally found that excitement in everything that I'm doing again. I finally have a workout routine that works. I finally am back on my mental health slash like wellness part of life, where I'm really staying on top of that and I'm being consistent. And most importantly, I fell in love with content creation again, because that was my biggest thing. Being creative and storytelling and creating content online has always been my favorite thing ever since I was younger. And now that I've been able to turn my hobby into kind of like a job, I'm so grateful for that. But when I fell off of it, I really was struggling to connect with my audience and to just show my life again online. And so now that I have quote unquote found my spark again and all the things that I'm doing, I want to share it back with you guys in case you are also going through a little bit of a weird period in life and you don't really know what to do, where to begin, or which step to take. So let's get into some of the tips. Tip number one is reconnect with what you love to do. This can be your hobbies, your interests, anything that you really love. And a lot of it really connects back to things that we loved doing as a child. Bring that piece back, really tap into those areas of things that you used to love to do. And I also remember Haley Gamba saying in one of her YouTube videos, having hobbies as you are getting grown and as you're getting older is so key, because that really just lets you tap back into those simple parts of you where it doesn't really require much. Like a lot of what we love to do as a child, we can see it in little ways of the things that we do right now. And so reflect back on those things that you love to do, but maybe you keep putting on the back burner, and bring this back into your life. And it can be as simple as painting or drawing, playing an instrument, reading, gardening, etc. Like anything that you love to do, which brings you joy or which you used to do, really tap back into that. And for me, it really goes back to all the way back when I was literally in elementary school and in middle school. I had an iPad that I saved up for that I bought, and I was so happy because I was going to use it for games and of course filming random videos around the house. And then when I got my first iPhone, I was so happy because I was able to use that now to make little movie clips and do movie trailers like of my dog. I would literally just take random clips around the house of my family and I would make music videos on Video Star. Like I literally was just so obsessed with videos and content creation, and I would make my siblings and my whole family be a part of it. And so as I got older and I really started to get more comfortable on social media, posting online, I learned about TikTok and Instagram and all of these things, I was like, oh my gosh, like people can make a living off of this. And so I immediately wanted to tap into that. And if you guys are looking to become a content creator or you want to get into that whole world, I have a whole playlist on my YouTube channel about content creation. I've done Q&As before on how to get into it. I've talked about how to turn it into a six-figure business, like all of these things. So you can definitely go watch those if you're interested. But it really took me back to when I was a child, because it reminded me of when I would run around the house with my iPad. I would run around filming things with my siblings. And now I do content creation kind of like as a job, really for a living. And it has been the best thing ever. But tap back into those things that just bring you joy and make you happy. Tip number two, which is probably one of the most important tips, is set new goals but with a different approach. So when I say this, I'm not trying to sound like every other person on YouTube, like, oh, set goals and all these things. Like I genuinely mean do it with a different approach. So instead of just setting goals and just having something on a piece of paper or just putting words down, have a specific approach. And with this, I mean remember your why. Remember why you are doing everything it is that you're doing. Knowing your why brings you clarity with life. It lets you stay more focused. You're more on top of your goals, and that is what keeps you motivated. And knowing your why why not just applies with your personal life, but it applies with everything, even in business. You have to know your why for what is the reason you're doing everything it is that you're doing. And knowing your why is also so important because it helps you refuel your passion. It helps you refuel that excitement, and it gives you meaning to what you're doing. It helps you reconnect with really finding that spark in what it is that you do. And when I refigured this out, it really helped me find the love again in everything it was that I was doing. I used to work out for the wrong reasons. You know, maybe I really wanted to lose weight, or I wanted to be skinny, or I wanted to lose fat. When in reality, my why had to be, I'm doing it so I can feel good about myself. Why? Because I want to be confident. I want to be happy when I wake up and I look at myself in the mirror. Like, that has to be the why, not because it's for any other standard or to meet a certain stereotype. And even with social media, like, the reason why I am so on top of my content and posting and staying so consistent is because I think, why am I doing this? I do it because I love to be creative. I love to help change people's lives. I love to bring high value and advice to people online. And I love to encourage people that their dream life is within reach. I'm an older sibling. I'm the oldest daughter. Out of all of my siblings, I was the first granddaughter. And I feel like all my life, I've always had this kind of standard put on me where I have to be like everything all at once. I have to wear all of the hats. And I didn't have a big sister. I didn't have anyone that I could go to for advice or things. Like, I've always just taken everything up on my own, which is why now I take all of these tips and advice and things that I've learned over the last few years and I put it online so other people can learn. I give my sister this advice. Like, I really just try to take things that I've learned on my own and from experiences and situations and bring it back to people. And because of me doing all of this, I eventually want to be able to reach my goal of freedom in all aspects, which is, you know, financially, with my time, experiences, traveling, like all of these things. And you have to be excited about what it is that you're doing. Like, why do you want to do this? You want to go out there in the world with enthusiasm and curiosity of not knowing what can happen if you just set your mind to something and like seeing where that can take you. So some tips that I have within this that can help you be on track for finding your why and with resetting your new goals is make them realistic. Be real with yourself. Don't be like, I need to make $1 million by next month, because that's not realistic. Make these goals clear. What is it that you want to do and why? Have long and short-term goals, because there's a difference between writing goals down and having them be long-term for years down the road, or having them be short-term to complete within the next few months to a year. And I also recommend making a vision board to go with this. This can really add to that excitement aspect, because you can see it clearly and physically either in your room or on the wallpaper of your phone or your laptop, wherever it is. Just have something that is visual to pair with these goals so that you have it to remind yourself every day. The next tip to find your spark again is to surround yourself with new people and inspiration. So I know that it can be hard to find new people to surround yourself with. Like, I totally get that, especially when you don't really connect with anyone in your current life. I feel like I could do a whole podcast episode or YouTube video on this, because it's honestly so annoying and lonely when you are just in this new era of life and no one around you is like kind of on that same path. Everyone is really just still stuck in the past. And like I have said before in other videos, I've always felt like I'm very grateful for everyone that's in my life, but sometimes I just feel like with old friends, having them along when they're still stuck in life from the past, but you're so focused on the future, can really stop you from hitting your full potential. And within the last few years, I've really learned to just enjoy my own company. And I think I have a whole podcast episode on this where I talk about how to get comfortable with just being alone, like learning to be alone and enjoying that time. But while I learned to be more comfortable being alone, I've also learned the importance of why being around certain people can make or break you. And I've had friends before in the past that just love to talk about high school and things that happened in the past or drama from 7 years ago. And meanwhile, like, we are in our 20s and I'm just thinking like, okay, you peaked in high school. Like, I'm so sorry that that was like the best time of your life, because I am here like trying to focus on making the most out of my 20s. When you are around the same people who do nothing but complain and they're always mad at the world, or they always have like some sort of beef with somebody and they just never do anything to get themselves out of their environment. environment, it's okay to cut ties. And I know what it's like to be the friend that is always giving advice and all of these tips on, listen, like, this is happening to you, but why don't you do this instead? And then they say, okay, yeah, and then they never do anything about it. Like, those are the kind of people that you literally just should not have in your life. I'm not a confrontational person, like, I'm still not, but I really know when it's time to just start weeding out those dead plants. And so you want to seek out people and communities and things that can bring you closer to your dream life and the things you want to accomplish, because being around people that are on the same level and the same mindset as you is so comforting, because it's like, wow, I found someone who is aligned on the same things as me and we both have the same values. And it can be as little as taking walks in really nice neighborhoods and looking at the beautiful apartments or homes. Like the other day, I went on a walk with my boyfriend and his friends, and we walked through this really beautiful little town that had amazing homes. It was right in front of the water and it was stunning. And I was just thinking, like, I want to live in a home like this one day. I want to be in front of the water. I want to be surrounded by boats and have a waterfront view. Like, it really got me excited. And again, it's like just being in that environment, even if it's not physically around people, but physically being in a place where you dream of being in the future, that can get you really excited. And I went home that day and I was just like, what can I do to get closer to that dream life? Because I was already there physically. I was looking at it and I was like, I know that this is what I want. So start taking those things and actually applying it into your life. You know, cut out those people, weed out those dead plants, and just focus on that light at the end of the tunnel. My next tip is get out of your comfort zone and try something new. And this is the one tip that I never wanted to do, but it has definitely changed my life in the best way possible. And I have some examples that can actually help you guys resonate. And specifically for me, working out and social media are two of the biggest things that come to mind when I think of this. Like, I never used to like to work out, and I've said this before in other videos. I genuinely am just like a shy person when I'm in environments that I don't know. And so I used to go to a gym, which was like Planet Fitness, and I was always so nervous going in there because I didn't want to bump into anyone that I went to school with, and I would just always feel so uncomfortable, like people were watching me. But I knew that I really wanted to work out and I just didn't know what to do. So one day, which was 2 years ago, I was doing a bunch of research on different studios and workout places in the area that I live in, and I couldn't find any, but I found one specifically in the city over next to where I live. And a lot of these places let you take a free first class, so I brought my sister. We took a 6 a.m. class and we absolutely loved it. We loved it so much that we ended up signing up, and we just loved the whole community of it, the aspect of just going to the studio, having a little locker, there's showers, everything was just perfect. The playlist was amazing, and it ended up being Cycle Bar, which is a spin class. We became obsessed with it, like we loved it. But again, even though we hated the gym and we felt so shy and uncomfortable, we knew that there was something out there for us that would be a little bit more enjoyable, and now we absolutely love to work out. And same thing with walking. I never really was a big walker until I started incorporating things that I love, which is listening to YouTube videos and podcasts and interviews. And so I started doing that on my walks, and now I love to do it. And social media is another great example. Like, I never liked how I felt just being a consumer for all those years, because it made me hate my life when I was younger. Like, I would look at how my life felt so robotic. Like, I would wake up, I would go to school, come home, do homework, go to sleep, and do the same thing every single day. And I was looking at all these people online, and I was really comparing myself to the opportunities they got, the physical things that they had, their life and everything, and I wanted what these people had. And again, that's a really bad habit, like something that I've definitely grown out of as I've gotten older. But when I was younger and I was really influenced by these things, I wanted the life of these people I was following online. And so one day I just realized, like, everybody starts from zero, everybody starts from nothing. So if I just work hard like these people, maybe I can get the life that they had. And that's exactly what I did. The month that I graduated high school, I knew that I was never going to see these people again. I removed people, I unfollowed, and I was like, I'm gonna just go straight towards my dream, which is to be able to make money if I'm creating content, which is what I've loved doing since I was younger. I just never put it online because I wasn't allowed to. Now I realized I was able to just unfollow, remove, and ignore the noise and really just focus on my dream. And I tried something new. I got out of my comfort zone. I learned to be comfortable in front of the camera. By doing this, by getting out of your comfort zone, you start attracting all of these amazing people and opportunities your way. You really just have to let go of all that noise and just focus on you. next tip is learn to get comfortable with being alone. Like I said before, I have an entire podcast episode on just how to be your own friend and how to just learn to be alone. But by being alone, you are going to get to know yourself so much better. And I have friends that previously would just hate being alone. Like, it really overstimulated me, because I don't want to sound like that annoying friend, but I'm just someone that I cannot spend all day, every day, like 7 hours a day on FaceTime with you. I cannot just waste my whole day doing that. I cannot spend all day for hours listening about this guy is doing this to me or my boyfriend is acting this way. Like, I am always there for everybody in my life, but when it comes to a point where, again, they're just taking all the advice that you're giving them and not doing anything about it, it can be very draining. So these are all things that really just, again, contribute to that outside noise, and it just puts you off track from what you have to do. Because have you ever noticed, like, you get off a phone call like that and you're just like, what just happened? Like, why do I feel like I just wasted and, like, got my energy drained from this conversation or from being with these people? I'm there for my friends. I love to have sleepovers and do little fun things, like catch up with our life on the couch or watch a movie or something. When you are doing something that is just, like, wasting both of your time, it's like you have to reevaluate who you're around and what you're doing. And so by learning to just enjoy my own time in my room and in my house, I fell in love with it, because it really caused me to think and figure out, like, certain situations on my own without people giving me advice or without people saying how they feel. And by being alone, you can also focus more on your interests, and you can focus on what really matters to you. You are now able to make more time for what it is that you want to do, what makes you happy, and then all of this as a result lets you get to know yourself better. And in the beginning, it can definitely be hard, because maybe you want to keep scrolling on social media all day. Maybe you're like me and you want to just watch a YouTube video and ignore all of your work. But when you start using your time wisely to get back to yourself, whether it's journaling or going on Pinterest and finding writing prompts, starting a blog, starting a passion project, like tapping into these hobbies or just doing all of these things in your own time, in your own little world, in your own bubble, it's going to bring you further into feeling just so good about yourself, because you're getting to know yourself better and you don't have to depend on people to make you happy. You literally are just filling your own cup, and that is something that has brought me so many opportunities. Like, when I'm alone, I'm really able to just focus and do my thing, and that has brought me so many opportunities and so many amazing things. So if you are someone that has trouble being alone, or you like to be around friends and do all these things, it's not saying, like, completely cut them off, but definitely have a good balance of, I'm comfortable being alone. I don't always need to be with someone or around someone. But then also, when it's time for you to hang out with your friends and you need that, like, socialization, do that, because it's really good and important to have a balance of both. The last and final tip for finding your spark again is decluttering and simplifying your life. A big reason why you may feel lost or a little bit all over the place is because you may be in a messy environment. And I know in my other tip, I talked about how being around certain people and certain things can also really affect you, but also it can be where you're spending your time, where you're hanging out, and where you're doing your things. So if you are someone like me, where you have your desk in your room, but you also sleep in your room and you do everything in your room, it's important to keep it clean and tidy. And even if you don't do everything in your room, you want to just have a clean home and a clean space. And I'm actually going to be making a video here on YouTube about just how to be organized with everything in life, how to, you know, clean better, how to have a clean mind, a clean space, and just really reset when it comes to all that, because I love to clean. That is something about me that is so therapeutic. I love to clean and just organize and make sure that everything is in its right space, and just do something, like, every day that is at least one thing for you, one thing that is making you happy, and one thing that is just bringing you closer to your dream life. For me, it's journaling, reading, and taking a walk. Every morning I go on my 6:30 a.m. walks, and I like to listen to a podcast or a YouTube video or an interview, and that really sets my mood for the rest of the day. Because I notice on the days that I don't go on a walk or that I don't listen to something inspiring or motivational, I really get off track, and it keeps me off balance with the things that I'm going towards. So do something that is just for you every day. Sometimes it can just be one really big day during the week where you declutter and you clean everything. Maybe your pile of laundry is overflowing. Maybe you haven't cleaned your bathroom or washed your sheets in a while. Maybe you need a new scent, a new perfume. Like, whatever it is, just declutter and look at how you can really make your space your own. I have a vision board vlog where I just remade my vision board for the last 6 months of 2024, and I put on a bunch of quotes and things on there that I really want to just remind me that I am heading on the right path with my life and I am creating my dream life every day. Something really big that I didn't think was actually helpful but really is helpful is moving your room around and moving your furniture. My sister is the queen of moving furniture in her room like every few months because she really goes throughout her life with seasons, which I absolutely love, and I've been feeling the same way, but I never did anything with my room. Like, my room usually stays the same for years. I never really move it around, and a few months ago we got our entire apartment repainted and this caused me to move my bed, and I was like, you know what, I haven't moved my bed and my desk and everything in quite a while. I've kind of just been stuck in the same space for a few years now, and so I moved my bed to another side of the room. I have my desk here in this corner now. I moved my dresser. Like, so many things just got changed around, and when I tell you guys, I felt so different. Like, it felt very nice to just have a completely new space. I loved it, and now I completely see why my sister moves her furniture around every few months, because she can look back and be like, oh, when my room was this way, this is what I was going through. When I had my room this way, I was going through this. And you look back and you're like, wow, like, that is what I was going through. And now that I feel like I'm in this new era, my room has been completely changed. Everything was kind of like redone and repainted, and I'm like, I feel really, really great. Really personalize your space, make it your own, have a vision board, have pictures constantly all around that can just remind you of the path that you're going down. That is all for today's video. I really, really hope that these tips were helpful. I didn't want them to be the most basic tips out there that you can find on any other YouTube video. These have really been helpful for me to let me fall back in love with life again, because I'm telling you guys, the first 6 months of 2024 were not pretty, and now I feel really happy and excited for just everything. So thank you guys so much for watching. I love, love, love all of the support that I've been getting. You guys are amazing, and I will see you in my next video.